Obeying the Gospel, November 12th. No Christianity without correctability. They hate him who reproves in the gate, and they abhor him who speaks the truth. Amos 5, verse 10. The prophets sent by God to call for repentance in Israel did not always find a receptive audience. Israel, desperately in need of a radical return to God, often rejected the pleas of the prophets for a change of heart. Apparently, this was characteristic of the attitude of many of them about correction in general, even when it came to listening to the daily wisdom of their elders in the community. They were incorrigible. They hate him who reproves in the gate, and they abhor him who speaks the truth. In the New Testament, we hear Jesus lamenting the fact that Jerusalem had for so long rejected those sent by God to call them back from their sin. O Jerusalem, Jerusalem, the city that kills the prophets and stones those who are sent to it. How often would I have gathered your children together as a hen gathers her brood under her wings, and you were not willing. Matthew 23, 37. But what about you and me? Are we innocent of this error? Honestly, can any of us say that we've listened any more openly when confronted with the need for change at the deepest level? Israel's tendency to abhor him who speaks the truth is, unfortunately, a human tendency. Every one of us resists being reproved. And if the Hebrew prophets were hard to hear, the gospel of Jesus Christ is hard also, for the very same reason. It requires enough honesty to admit that our fellowship with God is broken. Unless we change direction and seek God's forgiveness on His terms, we'll remain alienated from Him forever. Frankly, not many people are correctable enough to listen as humbly as the Bereans did in Acts 17, verse 11. They received the word with all eagerness, examining the Scriptures daily to see if these things were so. Wisdom is a curious thing in that it hurts us before it helps us. Although its benefits are enjoyable, wisdom usually requires some painful adjustments at first, starting with the admission that our present situation is not all right. And so it is with the gospel of Christ. It promises eternal salvation, but only to those bold enough to leave behind their current state. It's a journey that many will not make, because it's far too uncomfortable and costly. In the words of an old proverb, wisdom is a good purchase, though we pay dearly for it.